Growth for Fairfax Media continues to come from its online real estate business. A $15 million acquisition announced today is planned to bolster domain.com at a time when the newspaper business is facing critical headwinds. Fairfax Chief Executive Greg Hywood joins Macquarie on the final day of the 2016 Australia Conference to talk about management strategy and the upside for media stocks. Greg, thanks for speaking with us today.
Thank you.
Let's start with the proposed changes to the media ownership laws. Mm-hmm. How much of an impact do you expect that to have on M&A in the sector if they're passed?
I suppose my view of that legislation is it probably would have had more impact 10 years ago. I think the level of disruption through the industry, which is bearing down upon revenue growth across most of the traditional platforms, has probably mitigated the sort of immediate M&A activity. But once you get the legislation through, I think that various companies will try and maximise their scale, maximise their position.
And today you announced the purchase of a stake in Oneflare. What is that and how quickly will it pay for itself?
It's basically a home services business. So it's an app online. If you want an electrician, you want a plumber, you want a pest control agent, you want somebody to do something around the home, it's basically a one-stop shop. It's a high growth sector. It's enormously efficient for the providers of the services, and we believe it will pay for itself many-fold over a number of years.
And will any of that revenue be put back into the publishing business?
We don't see publishing as something that should or needs to be cross-subsidised. Publishing is something that will stand on its own. And as the digital print model evolves, we believe that there's a very profitable business down the track.
And other than the radio division, your market update today shows Domain's the main growth area. What impact would a drop in the housing market have?
Virtually nothing. I mean, Domain and REA, for that matter, are basically yield plays. And online listings businesses are relatively underpriced. And clearly, it's a very powerful platform. And clearly, it provides agents and vendors with the only proven way of knowing where a lead comes from.
And turning to publishing now, your presentation touches on ceasing publishing for both the weekday editions of The Herald and The Age, but also the weekend AFR. Mm. When do you expect this to take effect?
It's the sort of inevitability that is impacting upon all traditional publishers here and around the world. So all we were really doing is stating the obvious, but making it very clear both to our own people internally, but also to our investors, the direction we intend to take. And the bottom line of that was that we believe that there is an absolutely profitable and sustainable business here and that the downside risk involved in this is really quite minor.
And if you do go down that path, what impact do you see it having on ad revenue?
The beauty about this model is that 65 to 70% of print revenue already sits in the weekend and that there is print revenue during the week, particularly in the lifestyle sections, that you could transfer into the weekend. So that, together with the very, very large cost reductions that you would have by reducing the frequency of printing and production and distribution, it's a very sustainable, profitable model.
Fairfax CEO Greg Hywood, thank you for your time today.
Thanks so much.